to February and Friday. Yes, this is our first Fantasy Friday in February of 2024. Isn't that exciting? I hear people talk all the time about how long January is. Like, it feels like a whole year. It feels like 350 days. January sped by for me. I don't know if it did for you, but I am shocked that it's already February. All right, so I am Brenda, and I am here to talk to you about Fantasy Friday. But first, you know I have to say hello to some of my biggest fans, and my number one biggest fan is my daddy. Yes, indeed. And this Fantasy Friday is a labor of love for my daddy, so I have to say hi. Hi, Dad. I love you. And Judy, my dad's wife, my stepmother, Lisa, my best friend, and my Aunt Donna. They are always watching, and I really do appreciate it. And if you always watch, I would love to hear from you, and I'll give you a shout out too. All right, so let's get started, shall we? Okay, so if you're new and you have absolutely no idea what Fantasy Friday is, it's actually really, really simple. What Fantasy Friday is a day that I choose to get all dressed up and wear my favorite clothes or clothes that just make me feel happy. And it's really more than clothes. I realized back during the pandemic in 2020 that we have to stop waiting to use the things that we love, to use the things that make us smile, because we're waiting for the perfect time or the perfect day or the perfect guest, and we have to stop doing that. We bought those items because we loved them and they make us smile, so we need to use them more often. And it's not, like I said, it's not just clothes. It could be tablecloths. It could be your best china. It could be towels, linens, things that you save for other people but you're not using for yourself because either you think you're not good enough or you think that the time is not good enough. You know, why in the world would I want to use these beautiful linens on when it's just a Tuesday? Because you love them and because you like the way they feel. You don't need any other reason. Same thing with your towels and your china and your clothes. Get out your ball gowns and wear them to watch TV. So that is the concept of Fantasy Friday. Like I said, it's really, really easy. You just have to convince yourself that the stuff you have and that you love, it's okay to use them for you. And you have to stop thinking that they have to be saved for a better time or a better person. And I know that that can be hard for some of us, but when I started doing it, I realized that why shouldn't I be using them? Why shouldn't I get the use out of them that I want to get use out of? You ever hear about people who die and their family finds like their wedding china up in the attic and they never opened it and never used it, but they loved it? It just seemed like it was a waste. Well, you know what's a waste? It's a waste to not use things that you have and that you love, okay? And if you've been watching for a while, and if I've helped you at all to get into this mentality, I would love to hear about that. I would love to hear how I've helped you with your Fantasy Friday. And I do hope that I have, because I have helped myself. So I hope that somebody else has got some help out of it too, right? All right, so now it's time for me to show you what I picked for my outfit today. All right, here we go. This looks kind of summery, right? I got my cute new shoes that I got for Christmas with them, and I paired them with a really cute black necklace. Now my cat is sleeping. Come on, Oliver. He is sleeping on what I wanted to use with this, to kind of turn it into a wintry look. I've had this a couple years. It was a gift. I love this. I feel like it just, you know, classies up an outfit. I don't even know if that's a word. It's kind of classic and it kind of looks classic, right? So I really do like this, and I feel like it just adds a little something to it. You could add a black belt if you wanted to. I don't feel like it needs it because of the way that it's sewn, the little panels are sewn in. But it does look a little summery. But I think you can definitely turn it into a winter dress with just adding a few things. So what do you think? Like? Don't like? It's short. It's above my knees. Alright, so now it's time for me to show you one of my favorite products. Now this is a little bit different than what I normally show you because this is a kid's product, okay? But I really do like it, and I think that it's good to show you, okay? Maybe some of you won't ever use it. But alright, so this is kind of think of like an Etch-a-Sketch. But it comes with a pencil, okay? And you can make drawings on this, and then down at the very bottom, you click this button and it disappears. Now this hat comes with a little tie that you can tie it right here so you don't lose the pencil. This came in a 3-pack. It was really, really cheap. Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry. We bought the 3, and I know this has a dragon, one has a whale, and I don't remember what the other one has, and we gave one to Alani when we were at a water park, and she got so much use out of it, hours and hours, and then we keep 2 here, and I figured since she had that one, she got tired of it. No, she still uses the 2 at my house all the time, and I think it would be kind of fun for preteens as well, if each one has one, and they write something on, and then they give it to the next person, and I assume it could be fun for an adult to use, too. If you're like me and you can't draw very well, it's kind of fun to draw it and see and practice and practice and practice, and you haven't just used a whole notebook of paper, and you can kind of be like, oh, well, you know, Alani will say to me, draw a cow. Yeah, I don't draw a very good cow, but I can practice on it, and then when it looks bad, you know, instead of shaking it like you do, and that's just sketch, you just push that button and boom, it's gone. I don't know if I'll ever get to be better as an artist, but it is kind of fun, like I said. And so I highly recommend this. Even, you know, like I said, if you have kids in your house or that you give presents to, I highly recommend this toy. And this will probably be the only time that I'll recommend something for kids because I usually do it for adults. But I thought I'd do something fun for my first February Friday. All right, so it's time to go now. I love all of you. Daddy, I love you so much. I hope to see you sometime soon. Judy, Lisa, Aunt Donna, everybody who's watching, I love you all, and I hope you all have a fantastic Friday and a fantastic weekend and a fantastic February. And I will see you next week. Bye.